Hi, I'm Abby. This week, our devotionals have been following the theme of a God of promises. We've looked at Isaiah and Zechariah and Mary. And today, I want to think ahead to how we go into the Christmas season through the lens of a God of promises. My three-year-old has been talking about Christmas since October. He shrieks with delight when he spots a Christmas tree and asks complicated questions about the mechanics of Father Christmas's reindeer. He sings jingle bells loudly and on repeat. It's glorious to do Christmas through a toddler's eyes, and a tad exhausting. But it's also got me thinking, how much of his sweet, impressionable mind is focused on the promise of decorations, presents, and chocolate? And how much is engaged with understanding the Christmas story? Because even for adults, Christmas can feel a bit like this. There are lots of things in my box. There are presents to wrap. There are Christmas cards to write. There are decorations to put out. There is a table to set and meals to prepare. There is a tree to buy and ornaments to place on it. And often, Jesus gets left in the bottom of the box as an afterthought. Jesus gets left in the bottom of the box. In the last few devotionals, we've looked at how Jesus' coming was promised, not as an afterthought or an idea on a whim, but as a plan that spanned from the very beginning of time to countless generations. Jesus was the very opposite of an afterthought. Jesus was the fulfillment of a promise made to Adam and Eve, a promise to all mankind. We may mess up, we will get it wrong, we will fall prey to Satan's lies, but God has the final say. He will not leave us nor forsake us. In fact, he's won the battle. What does that mean for us as we enter into another Advent season? I think it means three things. Firstly, this Advent, let's grasp the enormity of the promise of Emmanuel. Let's step away from the gorgeous carols and lights and presents and instead turn our eyes to the child lying in the manger, the infant who embodied not just the fulfillment of a promise, but who also set about the rescue mission for mankind. Secondly, this Advent, let's rejoice that we're saved. Let's lean into the promise that there's nothing, nothing we can do to separate us from the love of God. At Christmas, we remember that God never abandoned us. In fact, he sent his own son so that we could be in right relationship with him. That's what we should be celebrating. That's worth celebrating. And thirdly, this Advent, let's reflect anew on the character of the God of promises. Are you like Zechariah, doubting that God can answer your prayers? Are you like Mary, surprised by the promises God has made to you? Or are you like Isaiah, carrying the promises of God in your heart, desperate for others to hear the good news too? Wherever your heart is this Christmas time, I pray that God will ignite a fresh zeal within you to grasp this wonderful promise of hope that's offered to each of us. I want to read that most famous of passages at the start of John's Gospel. John chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. The Word became flesh for you, for me. God's promise plan came to fruition. Let's rejoice. I'm going to pray, and I'm going to pray words from a song by Phil Wickham. Let's pray together. Glory be to you alone, King who reigns from a manger throne. My life, my praise, everything I own, to Jesus the King on a manger throne. Father God, what glorious news that you became flesh for us, that you promised to save mankind. This Christmas, let's not leave you as an afterthought, but let's rejoice and celebrate that you came to earth for us. Amen. This is our